Mural. It's full of color. It's a pleasure to be able to work with CITYarts to get this done along with SVA. I'm really excited about the mural. I'm excited about the community members that are coming in. I'm excited about the way that it's going to brighten up this neighborhood and bring this community together. I've done several murals, and this is by far one of the most collaborative pieces that I've done, so I'm really excited about it.
Hi, my name is Greg Emery. I'm an artist, and I'm also the head of visual arts at the Trinity School. So I live in the neighborhood and I work in the neighborhood, and just happened along this project, and it's great to help out with it. So I'll get to see it every day. I also love the fact that it's so public. Everybody's been really happy about seeing this transformation. And as Winston Churchill said, we shape our buildings and then they shape us. So it's nice to have a positive impact and make some decisions about shaping ourselves.
So my name is Mi Yang Sun. I come from China. I'm learning in the art education department at SVA. I'm an art educator. So I very enjoy this project because I think the mural is a gift for this community to show how we love this community and our passion as artists to the city.
Live in the neighborhood?
I do. Hi, my name is Kathleen Tanel Handel. I've lived in this neighborhood for, my gosh, 25 years or so, and I was just walking by and saw this beautiful mural being painted by a group who I'd love to know more about, and I really appreciate it. A lot of people walk by here every day, and it really is going to make it. beautiful and give us all something to smile about, so thanks a lot.
My name's Ebony Brown, and this project kind of means, like, you know, building up, you know, taking something that's falling apart and, you know, turning it into something beautiful to, like, help the community. So that's why I chose to work on it.
I'm Kenya Cobbs, and I guess this project means, I don't know, it's like a beautiful poem to me. And I like how it comes with illustration on the side of the poem. So I think it means strength, to be honest, like about how no matter what the circumstances are, you can still bloom and become a beautiful flower wherever you are. No matter your beginnings or your endings, you're still a beautiful flower in the end.
I'm from Hunter College High School. And I mean, I'm going to be honest, initially I did sign up for this just for the service credit, and because I would like to be doing something that I like to do, like, you know, art, painting. But after I started working on it, I saw a lot of people coming by saying thank you to us for restoring the mural and making it look better. And I was really surprised at that because I didn't expect for there to be that much of a positive reaction. So that's pretty much why I'm still working on it.
Hello. My name is Izzy Liberti, and I'm an intern. On-site intern for CITYarts right now. You know, I always appreciate public art. I appreciate anything public that's accessible to anyone of any socioeconomic anything. So I think the reason that I really appreciate being involved with it is that it feeds back into the mentality of art is something that anyone should have access to, and it shows. I think people on the street come by, and it's been overwhelmingly positive, the response, so it feels good.
Something like that.
Around that time. And I think it's gorgeous, and I think it's becoming even better than it was before, since before it was like chipped and coming apart. Now it's like we restored the whole thing, we made flowers prettier, the poem is still as gorgeous as it was before. So I just think that it's come a long way, and I'm glad that we finally got to restore it and make it as beautiful as the poem is.
It feels good to, like, give back to the community and help, you know, bring back the beauty. So, yeah.
I'm really impressed with the way everybody is working as a team, and the whole design flows together beautifully. We notice it every time we walk across the street.
She's an art, retired art teacher.
Oh, I love it. I love the colors. They're very soft, very warm, and they're all this. The color works very, very well together.
Yep. I was wondering how they were doing their lettering, and now I found out.
Look at you. You look like you belong with this mural.
I photographed with people who studied or worked for Ansel, and this is just to keep my eye in. I think it's lovely, and I thought here's an opportunity to get an image which I can then rework of the wall being done.
Absolutely beautiful, it made me smile.
My windows actually look out over there. So it's just very uplifting to see it when you come out, you know, it's just really fun. And I also love her writing. I
buy this thousands of times because I live right down the block. And I couldn't even repeat to you what the words say, but when I saw that they were redoing it, I was incredibly happy because it was dying down and, you know, I didn't really think anyone was paying attention to it. Thank you.
They look very good.
I was living on this block when the first one was painted, and it made me sad that it had gone the way it did. So this is great. I'm so appreciative, and it's so nice to walk down the block.
I feel good about it.
So I've lived in this neighborhood for like, you know, all my life. I'm 18 years old, so I've lived here for 18 years. And it always used to be really like decrepit and old, and like it's probably the coolest thing ever that you guys are rebuilding this. So it looks beautiful. I had to walk across the street just to look at it, to see the progress. I come here every day just to say hello and check the progress. So this is awesome.
Hi, my name is Luis, and I was walking down on Broadway and I saw this beautiful piece, and it kind of reminded me of my son, that he's six, Mateo, and he's kind of like a rebel, so I wanted to take a picture and show it to him, and you know, we're leaving to move to Chicago. I'm leaving tomorrow, so I just wanted to take a picture and kind of like, you know, remember New York, and this mural seems to be very, you know, a new beginning for New York, a wall, and also kind of like, you know, maybe coming back and seeing this would be great. So, you know, it's a great work of art.
And she's like, wow, look at the wall, and they start reading the poem together. I mean, it was so cool. You know, even people who don't maybe normally appreciate art, you know, when they come across something like this and it makes them smile, and you know, whether they think they know anything about art, it just, you know, this touches everybody, and it does what ultimately art is meant to do, to inspire and make people just a little happier.
Doesn't matter. If they're going to graffiti it, they're going to graffiti it. They're not going to say, oh, I respect the checkers. Can't come for the checkers. Happy life with the machines scattered around the room. Look what they made it for me. Happy technology. Outside the lions run. Feeding on remains. We'll never leave. Look at us now. So in love with the way we